Level up your image game with these 5 killer masking tips and tricks, guaranteed to give your visuals that extra edge and take them to the next level. And don't miss the bonus tip at the end of the video. First, we'll create a dramatic background light for the subject. Creating a radial filter for the background. As the subject shouldn't be affected by this mask, using Subtract Select Subject to remove the guy from the selection. Adding warm colors with brightness to this mask. Also removing the details with the negative value of dehaze slider. Adding one more radial filter and making it further bright to basically create a sun. A radial filter inverted to create a vignette effect. A color range mask to pop the dry leaves on the ground. Couple more radial filters to create some added light. Another filter to create a shadow of the subject. Other final touches to get the intended result. To create a dramatic landscape light to this image, adding radial filter inverted to create a vignette, another to brighten the lit areas. Creating a oval shaped radial filter to get this effect of sun rays falling on the monastery. After some color tuning, adding one radial filter on the horizon to get this dramatic evening light effect. Linear filter to add some darkness to the bottom, which makes center parts of the image pop more. After some color grading, the result is here. Now to switch on the lights on this car. After making the whole image darker, now using a radial filter on the headlight and adding brightness. Also the temperature to make the colors warm. You can also add orangish tones from the color box. Duplicate it and place it on the other light. Add one more smaller filter now and make it more brighter with warmthness. Adding the same to the other headlight. Make some other adjustments to get the surroundings and evening look. Before and after. Creating a hazy looking background to this. Selecting the subject, inverting the selection for the background mask. Adding haze, removing details which brings the subject into spotlight. Also adding a cooler color to the background. Some interesting effects by adding linear gradient filter at the bottom to make it dark. Also a radial filter to get this bright light spot at the top. This gives this hazy effect to the image. Now for the fog effect. Making the image a bit more muted by desaturating the colors a bit. Adding background blur with the blur filter. Making some adjustments by adding mask on the subject and the foreground. Mainly bringing out the brightness on the foreground. With a linear filter, minus the subject, adding haze with the dehaze slider. More haze at around the feet of the subject. Extra touches to finally get this result. Now for some color grading bonus. Changing this to this output involves moving the green and yellow hues to adjacent colors in the color mix menu. Saving and repeating with the changed colors could turn any color to almost any intended color. In this case, pinkish or light purple color, whatever you want to call it. To make it remain only on the tree leaves, I used Snapseed double exposure to mask out only the tree leaves. Some extra elements were added to get this final output. You can watch the full tutorials of all these. I've left the links in the video description. Hope these tips and tricks were useful to you all, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.